Let's start. My name is Matt Gonzalez. I'm Ralph Nader's vice presidential running mate. One of the themes that we've been trying to push is to counter the themes coming out of the two conventions of the major parties, particularly the Democrats, who are trying to posture themselves as opposition to George Bush and a critique of his regime. They decry the crimes of George Bush, yet they don't tell the truth about their complicity and their, in effect, capitulation to George Bush's policies. They have supported his war appropriations. They have voted for the Patriot Act. They voted for the Foreign Intelligence Surveillance Act amendment. And you now see the Democratic nominee, who also supported all those things, changing his position on issues like offshore drilling. Both major candidates of these parties, John McCain and Barack Obama, believe that we need to increase military spending. This despite the fact that we're spending about $189 billion in the war in Iraq and Afghanistan, but we're also, in addition to that, spending $507 billion a year on our military. And that's from Travis Sharp. He's a military policy analyst at the Arms Control Center. We don't support that. We are trying to change and expand the political discourse in this country. And of course, we'd like to debate our opponents. We did an event recently with Governor Jesse Ventura of Minnesota. He shared with us his experience of having been at 9-10% in the polls when he ran for governor. He was allowed into the debates, and he won that contest within 7 weeks of being in the first debate with 37% in the polls at closing time. So he was elected governor with those numbers in a three-way race. I served as president of the board of supervisors in San Francisco and California. I ran for mayor in 2003. I started that contest in the polls at about 4% and 6%. I was allowed into the debates and finished that contest with 47% of the vote. I think you know Mr. Nader's long history. He's worked on all kinds of legislation, from clean air, clean water, helping create the Environmental Protection Agency, the Freedom of Information Act. We think he has a legislative record that is far superior to the nominees of the two major parties. I myself represented a jurisdiction as the president of the Board of Supervisors in San Francisco, a city whose budget of over $6 billion is roughly equivalent to the budgets of the state of Alaska and Delaware combined. I represented a city that's larger than the state of Alaska's population, larger than the state of Delaware's population. And when I ran in 2003 for mayor, I got more votes than Joe Biden did the first time he was elected to the U.S. Senate. The point that we're trying to make is we are experienced and serious politicians. I worked on helping create the largest, highest minimum wage in the United States of America with an indicator for inflation that goes up on its own. We've worked on serious legislation, and we think that we have the qualifications to engage the American people if we're given an opportunity. And I'll close just by saying, you know, as members of the press, I would urge you to reflect on the importance of conveying this message. You know that this democracy needs to be repaired. You know that it's not appropriate to present this contest as simply a two-party contest. We can't fix things without your help, because you help get that information to the public. And when, you know, people try to say to us, oh, well, you're not serious or you don't have enough support and that sort of thing, it's a sort of chicken and an egg, you know, horse before the cart type thing. What comes first? If you don't let us in the debates, we can't reach millions of Americans. Thank you.